My first tip when it comes to utilising Outlook is all around mastering quick steps. What they do is they are basically like mini rules that you can set up to make Outlook carry out certain functions. And quick steps can be found in two locations. The first one is up in the Home tab and then on the ribbon under the Quick Steps command group, or if you right click on an email and then go down to Quick Steps, you'll find all the available options are there. So there's two places you can get hold of them. In this particular example, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use the one in the ribbon just because it's easiest to do. So first thing we need to do is we need to set up a new quick step. So I'm going to click on Create New. I'm then going to give my quick step a name. And the next thing I then need to do is create an action. So here, if I click on this drop-down menu that says choose an action, you'll see there's loads of different action types. You've got stuff for changing, filing state, change status, assign categories, respond, loads of different actions that you can carry out. In this case, I just want to keep it quite simple. So I'm just going to click on move to folder. Next, I'm then going to go and select the folder. So I click on the drop-down arrow, go to other folder, and I'm going to select training. Once I've done that, I can then also assign a keyboard shortcut key. So I can click into here, and here are the list of the available keyboard shortcut keys. So I've got Control-Shift-1, and if I press that, Quick Step will automatically run. And I'm just going to click on Finish. And as you can see in the Quick Steps, my Move to Training Quick Step is now there. So if I want to run this, all I do is select my email and then go to Move to Training. And that email has now been moved from my inbox into my training folder without me having to drag and drop it. So again, it gives me that ability to speed up how I work. Now with quick steps, you can get them to do more than one thing at a time. So I'm going to go and create a slightly more advanced rule. So this time I'm going to click on create new again. I'm going to call this move and email. I'm going to select my first action. So I'm going to click into the drop down menu, move to folder, and I'm just going to go back and select my training folder. So it's very similar to the action that I did last time. But what I also want it to do is I want to forward this email onto my line manager. So I can go to add action, select what I want to happen, and I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to go to forward. I then can select who I want to send this email to. So in this case, I'm going to select Tom. And I'm going to select Sarah. Once I've selected those individuals, then all I have to do is click on Finish. And this time, I've now got the option, or the quick step has been added saying move an email. But this time I'm going to launch it from a right click. So I select the email, right click, go down to quick steps, and I'm going to select move an email. And as you can see, what's now happened is my email's been moved, but it's also now ready to forward onto both Sarah and to Tom. So it's, again, saved me an extra couple of clicks. And then all I need to do is click on send to finish the process. My second tip is all about managing attachments within Outlook. This is, again, a really nice, useful piece of functionality. So all I'll do is just create a new email. I can obviously just click on the new email button, or I can use the keyboard shortcut, which is Control and N. When you're in the email, just go into Insert and then click on Attach File. What Outlook will now do is it will give you a list of all of the files that you've recently used, and you just need to select the relevant one. So I'm going to go and attach this OneDrive script. And then I'm going to just click on send. My next tip is all about helping you proofread your email. Now, Microsoft added in some new functionality a couple of months ago called Read Aloud. And what this lets you do is essentially get Outlook to read your email back to you. So to do this, all you need to do is just highlight the part of your email you want to read back. So in this case, I want all of it. And then just go to the Review tab and click on Read Aloud.
Dear Bob, video provides a powerful way to help you prove your point.
And as you'll hear, you'll get the Microsoft Assistant read your email back to you. It's an extra level of proofreading. So before you send it off to anyone to get reviewed, you can go through and just get a bit of a better feel for how the email is going to come across. So my next tip is all around just making Outlook a little bit easier to use. So generally, when people want to have a look at the calendar, what they'll do is they'll go and click onto the calendar icon to open up today's calendar, and they'll basically start to move from their inbox to their calendar to their contacts to their task list. And Outlook has a function which is called Doc View. So if I hover over my calendar, I get a preview. But if I right click and then go to Dock the Peak, on the right hand side of my screen, what will happen is I'll now get this new peak view, which will show me all the activities that I've got coming up for today. So you've now no longer got an excuse to be late for a meeting.